Cześć, jesteśmy na stoisku Prusy i jest tutaj z nami Marcel z oczywiście Prusy. Hi Marcel.
Welcome.
Hi Rafael.
Thank you for taking time to talk with me.
No problem.
We have here the Prusa Core 1 with nice system with many nozzles. We have 8 nozzles here, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. How fast they changing from one color to another?
Right now here we are showing it at about 15 seconds from the print to the print back. It's not about only changing the nozzles, it's about like purge tower and back to the print time.
Oh,
so 15
okay.
seconds, but we're aiming towards 10 seconds once it's completely full released.
Okay, so there is going to be some adjustments in the firmware probably?
Exactly, and also like in purging and stuff like
okay.
that.
So, but it's still amazing how fast it's happening, because if you blink, you don't gonna see it. And it's 15 seconds, and it's doing everything within 15 seconds. So there is the only purge tower, you said?
A little one, a very,
okay.
very little
very,
one.
Very
you should take
one.
A look
okay.
in the back. It's like super tiny for
okay.
8 colors.
We will record it later. So
it just makes some B-roll.
Yeah, it is small. It's like 1 centimeter square or something like that.
Might be a bit smaller in the final version.
Okay.
Right now it's on the safe side to show
okay.
everything fine working.
I heard some people were complaining that it's blocking the view, so...
Yeah, that's a problem. I already heard some people saying like, I will switch to clear panels on the side so I can see it. But nowadays you usually don't need to look at the print or
yeah.
like the first layer, because it's always perfect.
But you also have this camera on it, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, so you can just take a look on the slicer and see what's happening.
Absolutely.
But it's mesmerizing.
Yes. I always say it's like the snake from Book of Jungle. Is it called like that, the movie?
Yeah, probably.
Which is hypnotizing you.
Yeah, yeah, this one.
You're just like standing there and being hypnotized by what's going on.
So you put 8 nozzles here, right?
Exactly.
Am I saying it correctly? This is the nozzle.
It's correct. This is just a nozzle. So there's no electronics. It's just a filament going there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a nozzle, some heat sink, a smaller heat sink, some silicone. And it's completely contactless. Or like,
okay.
yeah, it's contactless, measuring temperature and inductive heating.
Mm. Amazing, amazing. So right now we have 8. And it's for here. Are you able to put even more, or it's...
On the Core 1 there's no more space, but there will be the possibility to have even 10 tools on the Core 1L.
Okay.
But then
okay.
it's the question, where are you going to put the other spools? So 8 is already a lot.
Yeah, that's true. Basically, it's hard to print something with 8 colors. I mean, it's... I tried that, and it's not so much models available,
yes.
right?
Absolutely.
So I think 5 is totally enough.
4, 5, 6, maybe 7, but 8 is
yeah.
really a lot.
Yeah.
But it's not only about printing in multicolor, but also printing in multi-material. It's
yeah.
possible to print TPU, PTG, PLA in one print very fine.
Okay, so you just choose the material, and you can like do supports from different material or...
Exactly.
Yeah, okay.
And there will also be the possibility to have different sizes of nozzles, so
oh.
you can choose between 0.2, 0.4, 0.8 or something like that.
Cool, so you can even get to one print in a faster time.
Yes.
So yeah, the infill will be like bigger and
exactly.
outer walls
yes.
or details. Amazing, really amazing. I want to buy one now.
I bought one.
With discount.
No, without discount. But I want it so bad, so I bought it.
Yeah. Can you tell me something about filtration system on it? It's like, because I saw...
It's a possibility to have it. It's an additional add-on for the back.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're printing PLA and PTG, it is not really necessary to have
mm-hmm.
filtration.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're going with ABS, ASA or something like that, you would like to have that. And that is an additional add-on you can
okay.
buy.
And the back to the nozzles, right now it's changing the color. You said it's like contactless, so it's like induction heating?
Exactly.
Oh, okay, okay. So it's like coil and like...
But the coil and everything is on the tool head.
Mm-hmm.
It is just a very thin tube of metal. Maybe we can show you one of the nozzles, how it looks like.
Okay, so this is the nozzle.
Exactly, this is the nozzle I spoke about. As you can see, it's very, very thin.
Mm-hmm.
And right now it's a 0.4 millimeter nozzle,
mm-hmm.
but there will be also other options available. And it's passive. There's no electronics, mm-hmm. no nothing. It gets induction heated, and so the temperature will be measured contactless. And filament will go here, will grab it and normally extrude it. And this is like the thing which is catching up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So the question was, why is the hole here?
so it can grab the filament through here, because you need to extrude it. It's a direct drive.
Okay. The radiator is pretty small. Doesn't affect the heat creep on it?
Oh, no, it's very small and it's not storing a lot of heat because there's not a lot of mass. Mm-hmm. So the heat very fast disappears.
Okay.
This is also why it heats up very fast.
Okay. And the last question is that if you want to change the size, you change everything that you hold? Or?
Exactly. This is one unit you can change. Okay. I'm not too sure if Bontech is going to supply this in single one, but usually you'll change the whole thing.
Okay.
But it's like 35 euros per one unit. Mm.
And it's hardened?
It's hardened and high floors, like CHT technology from Bontech.
Cool. So you don't need anything else, basically?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. So it's not on the sale now, or
it is on sale kind of. The first 1,200 units as a founders edition were sold by our partner who invented this on Bontech.
Okay.
But they're already gone. So the next batch will be on Prusa side, and after that there will be regular sales.
Okay. So I read it's going to be like next year or something like that, or
Delivery is Q1 next year.
Okay. And the bigger version, the Core 1L, will be also on later date?
If you buy it now, you can put it to either the Core 1 or Core 1L, doesn't matter.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay. Okay, so thank you for your time. I think that we know everything that we want to know. The machine is amazing, and I think this will be very big demand for it.
So it seems like that.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you for your time.
Okay.
Bye.
Tak sobie siedzę i edytuję ten film i przypomniało mi się, że jeszcze tam później oczywiście rozmawialiśmy dosyć długo o tej drukarce, oczywiście to nie zostało nagrane, ale bardzo ważna rzecz jest, która mnie bardzo interesowała, to jest jaki ma przepływ ten cały system Bontecha. I okazuje się, że on ma przepływ około 40 mm sześciennych na sekundę, co oznacza, że jest to troszeczkę mniej niż sam extruder od Prusy. Co oznacza, że będziemy mogli rozwijać prędkości rzędu na przykład 500 mm na sekundę drukowania, może nawet niecałych 500, ale jak sami wiecie, no to Prusy nie rozwijają aż takich wysokich prędkości, przynajmniej z tego co mi wiadomo, ale wydaje mi się, że tutaj bardziej chodzi właśnie o czas zmiany tych kolorów, tych dysz, tych materiałów, co to właśnie to będzie miało wpływ na prędkość druku, a nie samo jakby przemieszczanie się dysz, bo jednak precyzja jest troszeczkę zatracana, kiedy mamy za dużą prędkość. Więc tyle ode mnie. Ja już dziękuję za uwagę, mam nadzieję, że ten filmik Wam się podobał, troszeczkę tam podpytałem ich o ten system, no i niestety, ale sprzedaż tych systemów ruszy dopiero w przyszłym roku. Smutna minka. No nic, dzięki za uwagę, do zobaczenia w kolejnym odcinku, cześć!